I don't believe we humans can continue on this planet with capitalism, socialism, communism, fascism, or whatever other ism you can think of that only operates within the confines of today's outdated trade system. I believe in a new way of thinking, in alignment with change, science, and sustainability, in alignment with the concept and causality of structuralism. If you want to focus on planetary improvement, then maybe stop consuming brainless media and instead read The New Human Rights Movement. The book is dedicated to the unpersons, those who embody the evidence of our grand social failures. And the wisdom gathered in it shows how building a new, sustainable social model could radically improve human relations and behavior. The author Peter Joseph shows that most social activist organizations only protest and fight against symptoms of the real issue. Symptoms like war, poverty, inequality, crime, violence, and corruption that actually are all caused outcomes of today's market structure from a systemic point of view. To the market, these problems are simply labeled as a negative externality, despite there being much better ways to distribute and share the planet's resources that does not excuse and threaten billions of people's reality. One also learns that our problems will not be solved by rich people's vanity-driven philanthropy. Their donations keep increasing, yet interestingly enough, so does global inequality, on top of the fact that they are extremely unlikely to question the very structure that rewarded them all their notoriety. Studies clearly show that the richer you get, the less you proportionately give. Maybe that's because millionaires and billionaires become so out of touch with how the average human lives. Peter exemplifies in the book how our mental health, physical well-being, and social inclusion worsen in a society with higher inequality. The economic system around us really dictates the extent of a population's relative and absolute poverty. All this makes me understand that today's free market is anything but free. It only serves and benefits those with the most economic leverage. It even reinforces companies to control and sell water as an artificially scarce beverage. We must stop looking at things as self-imposed or fixed. Everything, including our own behavior, is simply a link in an endless chain subject to the surrounding matrix. Our human rights must be integrated into the very structure of the social model. Otherwise, they will never be realized, regardless of what is judicially lawful. The fact that murder is illegal doesn't stop humans from being lethal. It is the forces of society and one's environment that determines the behavior of people. The same goes for trying to achieve sustainability in an unsustainable system. It's structurally impossible without redesigning the entire socioeconomic model that in turn would change incentives and ultimately the human condition. In order to do so, we must experiment and use the scientific method to upgrade society. If you haven't already, please look into the proposals of a new trade-free world. Automation, access, open source, localization, and networked digital feedback are five very important steps towards such an abundant future, enlightened by Peter, a smooth-talking human whose work is a great inspiration for how to bring about real structural change. To understand more, please read or listen to The New Human Rights Movement by Peter Joseph. Also, please check out Traumzeit, The Venus Project, and the Zeitgeist Movement. And if you haven't already, watch Peter's Zeitgeist Trilogy documentaries, the Culture in Decline series, and stay on the lookout for the new Interreflection film series. Thanks for listening, and as always, much love.
99% of human society exists without money and markets. A lot of people forget that too. So this isn't some inevitability of the way we live. What is the silver bullet that can possibly transform this negative trajectory that we're on? And that is structural change of the economy. Morality is not going to do it. Our free will is not going to do it. Our rational sense is not going to do it in and of itself, because we are so inhibited and dominated by the structural psychology generated from our social system.
Also, if you want to see more Tromp content and help this project grow, please support us on trompsite.com/donate.